فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. قال تعالى: ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا. This is a mention of the mercy of your Lord to his servant when he called him a call in secret. قال قتادة رحمه الله عند تفسيرها, قتادة is saying an explanation of this ayah, إن الله يعلم القلب النقي ويسمع الصوت الخفي. The Allah أبو قتادة قتادة is saying explanation of this ayah that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has the knowledge about the pure heart, and also he hear the insecret voice. وقال بعض السلف قام من الليل فنادى ربه منادات أسرها عمن كان حاضرا عنده مخافة. Some of the Salaf, they say he stand up in the Qiyam al-Layl during the night, and then he called his Lord, even those who are with him in the same house, they couldn't hear him, or the same place. فَقَالَ رَبِّي فَقَالَ يَا رَبِّي يَا رَبِّي يَا رَبِّي. Then he say, Oh my Lord. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لبيك لبيك لبيك. الله سبحانه وتعالى he said I am at your service, I am at your service, I am at your service. قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني. He said, oh my Lord, يعني my bone is become weak. أي ضعف وخار ووهن وضعف. فعلى العظم أيها الإخوة يبنى الجسم, على العظم يبنى الجسم. فإذا ضعف العظم فمن باب أولى ما هو مبني فوق ذاك العظم سيضعف أيضا. يعني on the bone, all the body is built upon the bone, يعني from عصب ولحم ودماء وغير ذلك. Everything that is like from nerves, meat and blood, everything is built upon that bone. If that bone is weak, everything is going to be weak. Because the foundation of the body is the bone. ولهذا فيقول بعضهم أن مخزون قوة الإنسان في العظم. فإذا ضعف العظم ضعف المخزون. They say that the reserve of the power of the man is in his bone. If the bone is weak, everything is gonna be weak. واشتعل الرأس شيبة, يعني all the hair, يعني the grey hair has spread in my head. والشعال أيها الإخوة, الشعال الرأس بالشيب دليل على ضعف جسم الإنسان. That's meaning when the hairs, white hair, I can say, رحمه الله, the white hair grows in the head, that's mean the power is gone. You mean it become weak? Not me, ikhwan. I'm still young. This is only for. For show, inshallah, we'll hide it with you. Astaghfirullah. يعني كما قال كان أباؤه من ذرية يعقوب. فكما ذكرنا من قبل أيها الإخوة أن أحد الأنبياء سأل ملك الموت فقال له يا ملك الموت يعني this is from the إسرائيليات لا تصدق ولا تكذب لكن يعتبر بها ف someone he asked the one of the prophet he asked the angel of death he told him oh, when he came to take his soul he told him oh, you came in and you didn't ask the permission before you come do you send some signs or you ask يعني that you're coming or you're close to coming he said yes قال له هل لك من علامات على قدومك قال نعم He said, we got any sign that proved that you're coming to take that soul? He said, yes. قال وما هي? He said, why is it? قال وفاة جيرانك. One of the signs is your neighborhood they died. When they died, this is one of the signs of he's close to your house. Also قال بياض الشعر. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. يعني when the hair become gray. وضعف البصر when your sight become weak أنه كذلك كثرة المرض when you feel sick all the time وضعف البدن when your body become weak too and there is so many signs when you feel those signs that know that you're close وكذلك أن الفضيل بن عياض رحمة الله عليه كان هو وصديق له عائدان من جنازة. الفضيل بن عياض was coming back from a funeral with his friend. فقال لصديقه ما كم سنك؟ واذكر نعم سبحان الله انظر إلى كلام أهل العلم. لا يفوتون عليهم فرصة في دعاء غيرهم إلى أو تذكير غيرهم بالله. وبما ينتظرهم من الجزاء والعقاب وغير ذلك. This is the way of the scholars. They don't leave any opportunity. If they find any opportunity, they call their friends to, they make them, كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ذكر فإن الذكر تنفع المؤمنين. They remind their brothers about the hereafter, about the last judgment. فقال لهم, قال له, كم سنك? He asked him, he told him, how old are you? He said, 60 old, yes. I'm only 60. A guy who thinks so that he's only asking for his age, he told him, I'm 60. قال إذا فأنت منذ 60 سنة وأنت مسافر إلى الله فكاد أن تصل. He told him that I'm traveling to Allah since 60 years and now you're 60 you're close to reach so that you're to where you're traveling to. قال إن لله وإنا إلى راجعون يعني all of us we are from Allah and we will go back to Him one day. قال هل فهمت معناه؟ Did you understand the meaning of what you have just said? إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ You just say it like that, did you understand it? الرجل نظر إليه Look at your قال وما الحيلة What you should do? He understood that فضيل بن عياض is go after behind his word is another meaning No one has understood قال هل فهمت معناها Do you understand the meaning of what you just say? قال وما الحيلة؟ What is the solution؟ قال أصلح فيما بقي ها؟ أصلح فيما بقي يغفر لك ما قد مضى وما قد بقي يعني do good in what is remaining from your life Allah will forgive you the past and the remaining نعود إلى كلامنا أيها الإخوة وأيها الإخوة أن زكريا عليه السلام لما طلب الولد لم يطلب الولد من أجل أن يورثه المال ويورثه الشهرة ويورثه كذا وكذا فهم كما تعلمون أغنياء عن الدنيا فقراء إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى As you know their brothers زكريا عليه السلام he didn't ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى supplication to give him a child just because he want to inherit his son give him let the money for him I make him rich give him the money no They look up to this worldly life, they diminish this worldly life. They look up to it down. Not like we look at it now, we look at it in the top, we want to get everything. We're always hungry with money. When you come to money, we want to take everything. We don't care about, we don't want to, we take everything and leave to our children. And we don't care about tomorrow, about the punishment. If we will be punished, we care, take everything from, we don't care if it's coming from halal or haram. This is the way of the Muslim in this time. ولهذا الأنبياء كان قصد زكريا كما ذكرنا هو أن يورث ابنه الدين والشريعة والدعوة إلى الله والدعوة إلى التوحيد. He wants his son to inherit the prophecy, wisdom, knowledge, that light that came from his forefathers, from Yaqub. Not he wanted him to inherit the money, as the Shia they meant, they pretend. وتبعهم في ذلك ابن جرير and also follow him and agree with him ابن جرير رحمة الله عليه وكحكاه عن أبي صالح من السلف and he narrated some of them عن أبي صالح from the سلف لوجوه in multi phases أحدهما قوله تعالى وورث سليمان داود. One of them in the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sulaiman, he inherit Dawud. وليس أيها الإخوة أي في النبوة والملك يعني أيها الإخوة سليمان inherit Dawud in the prophecy and the kingdom. It's not the heritage of money or wealth. كما جاء في حديثي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المتفق عليه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال نحن قال لا نورة ما تركناه فهو صدقة. The messenger is saying that we don't inherit, what we left is a charity. وفي لفظ أيها الإخوة نحن معاشر الأنبياء لا نورة. فأخبر الصادق والمصدوق أن الأنبياء لا تورة.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. وقد ذكرنا أيها الإخوة أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال نحن معاشر الأنبياء لا نورث. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said we are the group of the Messenger, the Prophet without inherit. فأخبر الصادق المصدوق عليه صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أن الأنبياء لا تورث أموالهم عندهم كما يورث غيرهم. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم he told us that the Prophet, all the Prophets they don't inherit as the others, it can be inherited. بل قال بل تكون صدقة من بعدهم على الفقراء. That the money that they leave, that they left after them, this is will be given as a charity for the poor people. And ولا يخصون بها أقربائهم. لا يخصون بها أقربائهم. They don't give it to their relatives. فقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا نورة ما تركناه فهو صدقة. وكذلك the saying of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم we don't inherit what we left is charity. فهذا نص على أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا يورث. ولهذا منع الصديق رضي الله عنه ما كان يختص به في حياته إلى أحد من وراته الذين لولا هذا النص لصرف عليهم. ولهذا because of this text, this proof, this evidence, this hadith from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Siddiq, the Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, the Khalifa of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used this hadith as evidence to prevent or to favor, to prevent the family and the relative of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he didn't favor them with that. The heritage of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And because of if not that hadith or that text, the family of the Marriage Messenger and the relative will inherit from him. وهم ابنته فاطمة وأزواجه التسع وعمه العباس رضي الله عنه واحتج عليهم الصديق في منع إياهم بهذا الحديث. And those who will inherit from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is his daughter فاطمة and their wives, the nine wives that he left after him, and also his uncle Al-Abbas رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. And he challenged them with this, with the hadith. And because of that hadith, he prevented them from getting that heritage of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقد وافقهم على روايته عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عمر بن الخطاب وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب والعباس بن عبد المطلب وعبد الرحمن بن عوف وطلحة والزبير وأبو هريرة وآخرون منهم. And they have agreed with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه عمر بن الخطاب وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب والعباس بن عبد المطلب وعبد الرحمن بن عوف وطلحة والزبير وأبو هريرة وافقهم غيرهم. And he agreed with them also others رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. والتالي أيها الإخوة أن الترمذي رواه بلفظ يعم سائر الأنبياء. And the الترمذي رحمه الله, the second phase is that the الترمذي رحمه الله he narrated the hadith with another saying that is include compromise all the prophets. فقال نحن معاشر الأنبياء لا نورت. And he corrected. And the الترمذي he narrated, he said that we are the group of the men that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he broke the hadith in another saying, he narrated the hadith in another saying, and he said that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said we are the group of the messengers we inherit. والثالث أن الدنيا كانت أيها الإخوة أحقر عند الأنبياء. This worldly life, the brothers, the messengers and the prophets, they look at it down. They even though not care about it. من أن يعني من أن يكنزوا لها أو يلتفتوا إليها. That this dunya they never take care of her or never gather the money, or never follow her or look after her. That's why in the hadith, when the Arabi came and the messenger gave him the money and he wanted to start, he said, رجعتكم من عند رجل يعطي عطاء لا يخشى الفقر. About the hadith of the Arabi, the Sahabi converted to Islam, and he wanted to describe, he said that he came from somebody, from a man, he said, he called himself a messenger, from a messenger, that he gave him money, that he don't fear the poverty, or to be poor. That's why the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, everything he get, he give. And he, wallahi, if you ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to make him rich, he will. It's something that is very easy to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, because Allah owns all the universe. ولهذا عمر بن الخطاب when he entered to see the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he entered to his room, his house, he saw him, he is not sleeping, he don't have no bed, nothing. He's sleeping in a carpet that is really, he has made some marks in the side of the Messenger, in the body of the Messenger. And even عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he feels sad toward the Messenger, I feel that he cried. Because he sees the Messenger of Allah, he told him, we see that the kings of Roman and the emperor of Persian, they have the big bed, very high, and they have the good life, and you are the Messenger of Allah, you're sleeping, just ask us, we'll make you a nice bed. And the Messenger, he refused. That's why you see the Messengers, this money, this worldly life, they don't care about it. And this is the way of the piety people, the righteous people, the people who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't care about this worldly life. doesn't mean nothing to them. They want what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, is preserving for them. They're seeking what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saving for them there. This life, one day we will leave it. كما قال عيسى بن مريم إن هذه الدنيا قنطرة اعمروها ولا تعمروها. عيسى عليه السلام, he said this worldly life is like a bridge, cross it and don't try to build houses and things in it and live in the bridge. If there is anyone who can live in a bridge, if you maybe stop your car, start building something, there is a car behind you, we want to cross, they will ask you move. I'm coming behind you, and this is life. You have to move to your grave, and another one coming. Yeah, you will move to his grave, and the other one is coming. This is, you are here to gather as much as money you can. Yeah? You are here to gather as much as good deed, good action. Not as much as palace. That's why one of the Salaf, one day, he was like was a mayor of a city in Iraq in the time of Abbasiyin, and he was wealthy, he was rich, and one day he built the palace, the beautiful palace in that city, and he called everyone in his city to look at his palace with the garden, with the rivers close to the river of Furat, and he called everyone to see that river, to see that palace. Everyone come that day to see that day will open his palace, everyone to see the beauty of his palace and his garden. And he told them, how do you, how is my palace? Everyone is saying, it's beautiful, it looks like this, this, no one has what you've done, it's got gold in it, it's got this and this is beautiful, we haven't seen something like that, even in our dream. And he said, if there is anyone of you in the city who didn't come to see my palace. He said, everyone is here except two men. But these two men, they don't care about this dunya. The people, they live in only, they even doesn't wear as good as the others. They poor, they don't care about this dunya. They told him, this is the one I want to ask. This is the sincere people I want to ask. And he called them, they brought that man to him. And he asked them, how my palace look like? How is it good? How do you find it? قالوا إن قصرك هذا لم نرى مثله في حياتنا إلا أنه فيه عيبين. Your palace, we haven't seen something beautiful as yours, except it's got two defects, two things that are not good. قال ما هي؟ قال إلا إنه يفنى ويبلى وصاحبه يموت. Indeed, is it might be destroyed one day, and the guy only will die. This is the two levels. قال, what is the solution? How I can find better? فذلوه على طريق الله فترك كل شيء وانصرف معه. ورؤيا بعد حين بيده خبز قد مرت عليه أيام. حتى صار ذاك الخبز خبز يابسا يغمسه أو يبلله في ماء الفرات حتى يلين ويأكله ويقول والله لو يعلم أبناء الملوك ويعلم الملوك وأبناء الملوك ما نحن فيه من النعيم لجالبون عليه بالسيوف. Then he said to them, when they give him the answer, the correct answer, that your palace has got two defaults, that the guy who owns it, he will die. He said, tell me about the solution. Then he showed him the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way to Tawheed, to live this worldly life, to Zuhd. Then they say, people who knows that, that mayor, they said, we saw him one day close to the river of Dajla, having a bread that has many days that already expired. It's not like us now, we see the date is 28, now we cannot eat it. For example, if today is 13, 13 now, because it's full of infection. And the messenger used to eat the bread, had maybe 2, 5, 8 weeks, maybe a month. And they make it tarib. Now we can't. We are in the 20th century now, 21, yeah. We're more civilized. We can't eat those things. Yeah. We are in paradise, ikhwan. We're living in paradise, maybe this is our paradise. Maybe we get nothing there. What happened? They saw him in the river of Dajla having that bread. If you maybe throw it on someone, you kill him. Because like rock, he's very strong. You cannot eat it. He put in the river of Dajla in to make it soft, to soften it. Huh? And then he ate it. He said, really, it's very delicious. He said, wallahi, he swear by the name of Allah, the kings and the children, they know the happiness that I feel inside me. They will fight me for it with a sword. My happiness. He's a poor and he says he's happy. Yes. The happiness, ikhwa, is not in money. The happiness is not in wearing new tubs. The happiness is not in having a beautiful wife, a big car, a big palace. You can't live in a big palace. You maybe have 80 palaces, 100. But at the end, you find him hanging himself somewhere. Fine. He's not happy. The happiness is here. When you stand up for Qiyam al-Layl and you make that conversation between you and Allah. When you stand up to pray Fajr and you pray the Fajr sincerely to Allah. And when you talk to Allah in your supplication, with humiliation, with khushu', with fear. This is the happiness. The happiness is if you're happy with what Allah provides you. If you're happy with Allah, with what Allah gives you, you're happy. But if you're rich, you have maybe a big kingdom, and you're taking whatever you want, it's for you. But you're still taking. Are you rich? Now you're still poor, because you need what the others have. You need more, and more, and more. That's why the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال, إِذَا أُوتِيَ ابْنُ آدَمَ وَادِيَ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ طَلَبَ ثَانِيَةً. If we give to the son of Adam, we give him one river, a valley of gold, he will look to get another one, another valley. If we give him that second, he will look for the third. وَلَا يَصُدُّ فَمَهُ إِلَّا التُّرَابُ. And nothing will close his mouth from that hunger, that need to gather more money, except debt. That does go inside his mouth, then he died. فَزَادَ بْنُ عَفَّانُ وَيَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَى مَنْ تَابَ. Allah will give forgiveness and will repent those who are seeking the repentance. وَالثَّالِثُ أَيَّا الْإِخْوَةِ أَنَّ هَذِي الدُّنْيَا كَمَا ذَكَرْنَا أَحْقَرَ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. This worldly life, أيها الإخوة, is something that the Anbiya don't look at it down. What about the Salihin? The Salihin, they won't reach to the level of the Anbiya. And look at how they look at it. They look at this dunya very down. What about the Anbiya? The Anbiya, they have reached to that level that we will never reach to that level. اعبد ربك كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. Worship your Lord as you see him. If you don't see him, he's watching you. We will never reach that level. You cannot reach it by... You have to reach it by struggling. Struggle with yourself. Our soul is full of bad manners. We have to make it pure. That's why we have to struggle. And you have evil. He's fighting you too. We have to stop our soul. You want this? You want to eat it. You want the grapes? No. You want to eat today grapes. You will eat this. And some brothers, maybe they want to make zot today. They will go, no. You want to, what do you want? You want grapes? You want to eat grapes. Ice cream. You eat ice cream. This is zot. You stop here from grapes. Take care of your ice cream. This is not... Stop. Just for that. الرابع أيها الإخوة for أن زكريا مر معنا أن زكريا كان نجارا يعمل بيده ويأكل من كسبها We have talking the first saw, and that Zakaria, he was carpenter. Used to work as a carpenter and eat from what he gained during the day. And Zakaria, whatever he gained, so only what he keep for his need, he gave it in his wife to poor people. He gave it as a charity. I just keep what he need. I don't never save for tomorrow. Like the bird. We have to be like, you see the bird, when he comes, doesn't keep something for tomorrow. Every day, he's looking for what he need. That as we have to save the Anbiya now. The Anbiya and the Prophet, they work and they get their own money from what they gain. And even though they spend it for the sake of Allah, for the way, from the ways, if they see if someone needs it, they don't care about themselves. They give to those who are in need first. لهذا أرحم الناس بالخلق العلماء. The people who has mercy about humans and about mankind is the scholar. Who are the first scholar who have knowledge about Allah? إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. Those who fear Allah from His servant, the scholars. And those who have more knowledge are أنبياء والرسل. And those who come after them, the ulama. وكان داود عليه السلام يأكل من كسب يده. داود عليه السلام was a king. I don't know, he's used to, they ask his people in his kingdom, put some money for me. Huh? I want some money for my son. He used to work to get that money. This is how used to be Dawood alayhi salam. To gain that money, he worked for it hard. This is how showing everyone who want to lead the nation, the ummah, he must not take her money. He must work for it and deserve it. This is the Anbiya. وكان الأنبياء والإخوة لا يجدون نفسهم إجهادا في كسب المال. They don't force themselves to gain more money. They work just for their need and live for what they need to eat and give for the sake of Allah and just worship Allah and use their day for worship and for knowledge and calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ويذكر رب العزة سبحانه وتعالى أن زكريا عليه السلام طمع في الولد في هذه السن المتقدمة. الله سبحانه وتعالى عليكم ورحمة الله. He mentioned that زكريا عليه السلام he desired or wished that son when he قال لما رأى عند مريم بنت عمران بن ماتان عليه السلام فاكهة الصيف في الشتاء وفاكهة الشتاء في الصيف. أن زكريا عليه السلام when he saw the fruit of the winter in the time of summer and the fruit of summer in the time of winter, then he remembered. وهذه أيها الإخوة كرامة من الله لأوليائه. When you become a wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you come close to Allah with your deed, with action, then you will see the karama from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فلهذا you can see what happened to Maryam alayhi salam. The fruit, who bring the fruits? She's in the room, she never go outside the room. Just for worship, cleaning the room, cleaning the ma'bad, then worshiping Allah, never come out. And she got the fruit of the winter in the time of summer. And the fruit of summer in the time of winter. And who brought her? When he asked her, قالت هذا من عند الله. When Zakaria عليه السلام, he asked her, she said, this is coming from Allah. إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide what the one he will. Without a coat. فعلم زكريا عليه السلام أن الذي يرزق الشيء من غير أوانه قادر على أن يرزقه الولد ولو تعذرت الأسباب. كيف ذلك؟ أن زكريا when he saw what he saw, he understood. He knew that the one, يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى, he gave or provide Maryam with something that is impossible. Human can't do. Then he knew that the one giving that things not in the time, or provided with that food, he can give him a soul, even if he's old, even if his wife, she's barren. Even if he's weak. Then when he supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he give him that walad, he give him that son, قال ربي أن يكون لي غلام وكانت امرأتي عاقرا وقد بلغت من الكبر عتيا. He said, oh my lord, how can I have a son when I am very old and my wife is barren? أي كيف يا رب, كيف يا ربي مع أني بلغت من السن مبلغة.
فإن آمنوا بمثل ما آمنتم به فقد اهتدوا وإن تولوا فإنما هم في شقاق.